Happy Holy Hump Day on this December 30th, the last Holy Hump Day of the year. I'm Pastor Robert. Welcome to this midweek time where I can share some spiritual thoughts and reflections with you, and an early Happy New Year to you all. So I want to talk a little bit about calendars since we are at the end of this year and getting ready to start a new year. I know at our house, we always get a new calendar to put up on the wall, and we always get a Westie calendar because we have Westies. And so there's a different Westie featured on each month of the year. So we have that ready to put up on our wall. But I want us to also think about how in our Christian faith, we also have a calendar, and it's provided by the church. It's called the liturgical calendar, and it gives us seasons during the year so that we can observe different parts of our Christian faith. And I want to share that liturgical calendar with you. You might be familiar with it. It's something we emphasize here at Athens First United Methodist Church. But I wanted to share this with you, and I printed off this liturgical calendar. This is a basic calendar of what it looks like. You'll see that the seasons of the liturgical year are color-coded, and right now we are in the Christmas season, and the Christmas season is actually 12 days. We call it the 12 days of Christmas, from December 25 through January 6, which is when we observe when the wise men came and gave gifts to the Christ child. And actually behind me here, I'm in the welcome center of our church. We have the Star of Bethlehem, which is the star that the wise men followed to offer their gifts to the Christ child. So we actually observe that on January 6th, the 12th day following Christmas Day. We're gonna actually observe it this Sunday since it's the Sunday before Epiphany Day. So this will be Epiphany Sunday. But anyway, we are in the Christmas season, and you'll notice that it's the color white, and white or gold sometimes is used. There are festive colors. And whenever you see white or gold, that means that we are to celebrate that part of the season of the church calendar. So we are celebrating Christ's birth. And that is a very special season, right, when we celebrate Christmas. And so I'm glad we get 12 days to do that. And then we enter, after Epiphany Day, January 6th, we enter into a time called Ordinary Time. And it's the color for that is green. And that is just a time where we jump from the birth of Jesus and we go into his ministry. And it's an opportunity for us just to grow through the teachings of Christ. And so that's what we do in this season. It's called the Sundays after Epiphany Day. And that will lead us to the season of Lent, which is the color for that is purple. And purple is a penitential type of color, reminding us of the importance of confessing our sins and repenting. And that's a 6-week season. And I believe it begins in the middle of February this year. And it begins actually with Ash Wednesday, when we remember our mortality and our dependence on God. And so that is the season of Lent, leading us up to Palm Sunday and Holy Week, and remembering the last days of Jesus. He was crucified on a cross. But then we have the Easter season. And so Easter is the beginning of April this year. And Easter is actually 50 days long. And it's a long season. It's not just Easter Sunday. We celebrate the resurrection of Jesus for those great 50 days. And that great 50 days leads us to Pentecost, which isn't marked on here, but Pentecost marks the conclusion of the Easter season, where we celebrate the birthday of the church, where the Holy Spirit was given to the early church to empower them to be in ministry. And so then following Pentecost and the 50 days of Easter, we enter into a very long season, as you can see, this long season called Ordinary Time again, just like what we had over here. And Ordinary Time lasts pretty much throughout the summer and even into November. So that's quite a long season. And it's a time of steady growth. So green reminds us of growth. And it's a time for us to focus on the life and teachings of Jesus. And so we go through that until we get to the fall season. And then we get to Advent, which we just recently had. And Advent are the 4 weeks that help us to prepare for the celebration of Jesus' birth. And as I've been saying during Advent, Advent is also a time that we look forward to the second coming of Jesus, when God will create new heavens and a new earth. So it has a double meaning, looking forward to the birth of Jesus and also the second coming of Jesus. And then you see how the calendar starts all over again. So we have Advent again, and we have Christmas, and we go through that whole cycle. So let me just share some positive things about it when we do observe the liturgical calendar. And I just jotted down a few things here. Well, first of all, the whole year, the whole liturgical calendar is based on the life of Jesus, beginning with his the anticipated birth of Jesus, and leading into Christmas season, where we celebrate his birth. And then, you know, we go into the other seasons as well, where we focus on his teachings. And then in Lent and then Holy Week, you know, we're focused on his final days that took him to the cross. And then the Easter season, where we celebrate the great 50 days and Jesus' resurrection. And then we go back to this long season of ordinary time, where we grow in our faith and follow the teachings of Jesus. So for a full year, you will have gone through really the whole life of Christ. And so that's, I think, a huge benefit that we have when we follow the liturgical calendar, because we follow through the whole life of Christ. I think the second benefit or positive following the liturgical calendar is that there are appointed scripture readings for every Sunday based on this calendar that match up with the seasons. And I love that, because it forces us to focus on scriptures that we might not normally have focused on, because we all have like our favorite scriptures. But if we only focus on our favorite scriptures, that might not lead us to grow and stretch in our faith. And so the liturgical calendar opens us up to these other seasons and scriptures that point us to the season that we are observing. So I think that's a huge plus. And that's something that we emphasize on Sunday mornings. We take those appointed scripture readings and we connect it with the season we are following. The third positive that I think by following the liturgical calendar is that it gives some rhythm to our spiritual lives. And so we go through these different seasons throughout the year. And what I like about it is, as you can see, there are moments of celebrating and rejoicing and these high moments during the year, like Easter, like Christmas. And then there are also some other special Sundays during the year that are also highlighted for us to celebrate. But it also has us focus on our need to confess and receive God's forgiveness, like in the season of Lent, and times of reflection and meditation, like Advent, like Lent. And then I love it that we have ordinary time, those green sections of the church calendar, where we just have this steady growth in our faith. And that is really most of what the calendar is. It's a steady growth in following Jesus' teachings and his ministry. So I'm just going to share that with you just so we can be more aware of the liturgical calendar. And you'll notice when I wear a robe and a stole for worship, the colors are connected with the liturgical season we're in, along with the sanctuary and the chapel altar cloths and the paraments, we call them. It all is the color related to the season that we are following. And we have some dear saints in the church that make sure we keep up with the different seasons, like the folks that bring this Christmas decoration out. This will get changed, you know, to a different theme. So I love that about our church. So be alert to those, and let's be in the rhythm of the church year and the church calendar. So just one last thing. We continue to be having our in-person 10:30 Sunday worship service, with masks and with social distancing, but we also offer the 10:30 live feed online through our church's YouTube channel. And you can view that even after that live feed. It's always posted there on our church's YouTube channel. You can watch at a time of your choosing if you don't watch it live feed. So that's going to continue as long as we can, as long as it's safe to do so. And this Sunday is, like I said, Epiphany Sunday. And we're going to focus on what it means for us to be seekers, like the wise men, growing in our faith this year. And we're going to be celebrating Holy Communion. What a great way to begin the new year than celebrating the sacrament of Holy Communion. So have bread and grape juice available there in your home for this Sunday when you participate on the online worship service. Or if you come here, we will have the individual sealed communion elements for you to pick up as you go to your pew. And then we will commune together. So I just wish you a happy new year and just pray God's blessings upon you in this new year. And also look forward to us following the church calendar again this year. God bless you.